Hey, what is up guys? Welcome back to Gear Spec. Today I'm gonna show you how to test the mass airflow sensor on a BMW E46, but it's pretty much the same process, same procedure on all cars. How to test the mass airflow sensor with wiring diagram and without the wiring diagram. They have a film or a wire inside them that reaches about 70 degrees Celsius above the air temperature. And that's how the mass airflow sensor measures. Like the air going in cools down the hot film or the hot wire, and that's how they determine how much mass of air is going inside the intake. There is two different kinds of sensor, guys. Apart from digital and analog, both of them could be either hot wire or hot film, and you can actually clean the hot wire mass airflow sensors because the hot wire is actually exposed and you can just clean it with mass airflow cleaner. You have to use mass airflow cleaner to clean it because the brake clean or any other solutions that are out there could leave a residue, a film above it, and would prevent it from doing its job. And they do actually get dirty because, as you can see, they are exposed and all the air that goes through, it has to measure it. And if the air is dirty, it is going to make that wire dirty and prevent from doing its job. And the hot film ones are actually protected by a case, by a plastic case. And I don't believe you can actually clean them because you can't actually see the hot film inside it, so you can clean it. Another thing is that the mass airflow sensors have a direction, so you cannot install them the way you want. To find where the mass airflow sensor is located, it's usually right after the air box, and it's in the BMW E46, it's right there. That's the guy. To test it without the wiring diagram, you have to disconnect the connector, and when you look at it, there's only three wires there, which are pretty much ground, voltage, and signal. And it's a good idea to start with the power supply. So to do that, we're gonna have to turn the ignition on, so to the second position, and then we're gonna turn the multimeter onto the volts, DC volts, and we're gonna measure, and we're gonna check all three of those and see where we get power supply. So all the sensors, or most of the sensors on a car, have a supply of 5 volts, not the mass airflow sensor. This guy needs 12 volts. So out of these three wires here, we are looking for one wire that has 12 volts. Turn it into the second position. With the plug disconnected, we need ground from somewhere, which I'm gonna get from the strut tower, and then we start checking all of these guys. We got nothing on the first one. We got nothing on the second. And there it is. We got 12 volts from the first wire, and that is the red with the white stripe. So I'll remember that, because checking the other two, we don't need to check this one anymore because we know this is the power supply. Turn the ignition off and take the key out of the car. We switch the knob to the ohm, or the continuity, on the multimeter. And we have only two wires left to check here, which is the number one and number two. So we'll start with the number one. And again, we need a good ground. There it is. We are looking for about 1 ohm, because now we know that the sensor needs 12 volts and our supply, the battery, has 12 volts. So therefore, using Ohm's law, we know that we only need 1 ohm. Now we know that the middle wire is the signal wire, and that is what we are going to measure with the car running and back probing the back side of the connector. So for that, we're gonna reconnect the plug back in place. Be careful. Before we set the multimeter, we need to know what kind of sensor we are dealing with. And there are two different kinds of mass airflow sensors, digital and analog. Digital measures frequency and analog measures voltage difference. To know what kind of sensor we are dealing with, we need to scan the vehicle. BMW, US vehicle, 2000. Okay. And 3 series E46. Here's 323i, 2.5 liters. And then okay. And wait until it connects. And from there, we're gonna go to data. And airflow sensor. So we're gonna start the vehicle now and we're gonna see the readings we're gonna get from there. As I'm pressing it slowly, we see the numbers change from 1 to 1.2, 0.3 now. We got the point, so we are measuring voltage and we know that we are dealing with a mass airflow sensor that is analog. Now that we know that we are dealing with an analog sensor, so we are measuring voltage differences. And now we'll select DC voltage. We're gonna start the car and we're gonna start revving it and we should see the voltage change. So you guys saw how the voltage changed there as I was revving the engine. And if you don't see that the voltage changes there, you know it is not good. So you replace that. Another way, a simple way of testing the mass airflow sensor is by tapping at it. So if you're having issues like at idle, your car dies, then one of the problems could be the mass airflow sensor that is giving the ECM false readings. And what you could do is by tapping at it. So you let the engine at idle, you come here and you tap at the sensor. And if out of the sudden the car dies, that is an indicator that this guy could be bad. To the wiring diagram here, we know we got three wires and there is 1, 2, and 3. And by just looking at them, SW stands for black on German, I guess. And GE stands for yellow. And RT for red, WS for white. So we got the red with white stripe, we got the yellow and the black wire. And by just looking at the diagram here, we see that the black is the ground and we see that the red and white stripe is the power supply. And as well, we see that there is a fuse for it that is 20 amps and that is the fuse number 3 on the fuse carrier engine electronics. And that fuse or this power wire is hot with key on. So as soon as you have the key in the second position or with the engine running, the wire here is hot all the time. Then we come here and then we supply signal through the yellow wire to the DME. By just looking at this diagram here, we see how much easier things are with when you have the proper tools and we have the proper information. Here we have another car. It's a 2004 Toyota Corolla and the mass airflow sensor on the Corolla is located on the airbox right on top of it right here. And as you guys can see, there is 5 wires going to it, which means the intake air temperature sensor is integrated into that. The downside about that is if the temperature sensor is faulty, there is no way of fixing it or repairing it without touching the mass airflow sensor. So you're gonna have to repair or replace the mass airflow sensor with the intake air temperature sensor integrated in it. And there is 5 wires. So we're gonna follow pretty much the same procedure. We're gonna turn the ignition to on position and we're gonna measure voltage to each one of those and we are expecting to see 12 volts, on one of these guys and 5 volts on the other. 12 volts is for the mass airflow sensor and the 5 volts is for the intake air temperature sensor. So let's turn the ignition on and check them. With the ignition to the on position, we're gonna start with the first one to the far left. And then we're gonna set the multimeter to the DC volts. And then, oh, right there, we can see that we got battery voltage coming from the first wire there, and that is the black color. Now we're gonna do the same thing for the other four because we wanna see which one is the other supply of 5 volts for the temperature sensor. So it's not the second, let's see the third. It is not the third, let's see the fourth. Oops. And there it is. So the fourth wire, which is the yellow with black stripe, is the supply for the temperature sensor. And from there we're gonna turn the key off again, take the key out of the car, and we're gonna check for ground. I believe there is one ground there because usually they share the same ground, and then the other two wires are the signals. At this point we're gonna set the multimeter on the continuity or the resistance. We expect to see 1 ohm resistance there because it requires 12 volts and battery supply is 12 volts, so we expect to see 1 ohm from the ground coming from the ECM. And we found it. So it is the far right connector or wire, and there it is, 0.678 ohms. So that is the ground, and that is the brown wire. To test the mass airflow sensor now, we have all the wires that we need, and we're gonna connect the connector back and we're gonna back probe them. And what we need to back probe is the ground wire, which is here on the brown one, and the middle one, which is green, for the signal. So let's connect it back, and we're gonna have to start the car for that. The signal wire, which is the green, and the brown wire, which is the ground, and then set the multimeter to the DC voltage, and we can start the car. And as you guys saw, again, we are dealing with an analog mass airflow sensor. So there was a voltage difference as you rev it. I got the wiring diagram for the 2004 Corolla. And it is looks a bit complicated, but it actually isn't. As soon as you realize where the mass airflow sensor is located, which for us is this guy here, and you see there is 5 different wires going up. And they are named. This one is a bit more complicated because you have to actually attach 3 different pages into one, so the wiring makes sense to what you are looking at. Compared to the BMW, if you have access to the wiring diagram, then you can see which one of these wires are for the intake air temperature and which one is for the mass airflow sensor. That is pretty much it, guys. If you have any questions, you can leave them down on the comment section, and I'll try to answer them to the best of my knowledge. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a thumbs up. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll catch you guys on the next one.